Hi, I'm Fiona.
And I'm Liz. This video covers the Alliance area. This is the area behind the Alliance wall where three drive teams from each Alliance control their robots and play the game.
Each of the three driver stations has a shelf for the team's operator console. On the shelf is a strip of loop tape for teams to utilize. We highly recommend that all teams add hook tape to the bottom of their operator console to help to prevent it from sliding off the shelf as robots hit the wall.
New this year, there is a sponsor panel in each driver station. This panel is 6 inches tall.
Every driver station is equipped with an Ethernet cable, which connects your computer to the field management system. There's also an AC outlet with a 2-amp fuse in case your operator console needs power.
Also on the driver station shelf is an E-stop and an A-stop. The E-stop button lets you disable your robot during a match. If the E-stop is pressed, your robot will be disabled for the rest of the match. When pressed, the button will stay in the down position and the amber light in the driver station will illuminate. The A-stop lets you disable your robot in auto, but not for the whole match like the E-stop. If the A-stop is pressed, your robot will remain disabled for the rest of auto, but will be re-enabled for teleop. When the A-stop is pushed, the amber light in the driver station blinks.
Stack lights at the top of every driver station relay quick diagnostic information to teams and field crew. Check out the game manual for full details. Shout out to Rockwell Automation for donating the E-stops, A-stops, stack lights, and for powering the station control cabinets.
Above each driver station is a team sign. The front of the team sign faces the field and displays the team number and the state of the field. Remember, you can only enter the field if deemed safe for humans, which will be indicated when the team signs are green and say safe.
As noted in the hub video, teleop is split into shifts. The back of the team signs relays that information during the match. On the left side of the display, the sign shows a letter and 2 digits to indicate which Alliance hub is active and the time remaining in the shift. A is for autonomous, T is for transition shift, E is for endgame, and R or B for which hub is active for the Alliance shifts. On the right side of the display, the sign shows the time remaining in the match overall.
During qualification matches, the center of the display shows progress towards 2 different ranking points. First is progress towards the fuel ranking point. It shows how many fuel have been scored and will show out of the lower threshold until it's achieved and then switch to the higher threshold. It also shows how many tower points were earned during auto to help teams track progression towards the traversal ranking point. During playoff matches, the center of the display shows the total match score for both alliances as there are no ranking points during playoffs.
The back of the match timer shows the time remaining in the match on the left and the total match score for both alliances.
There will be a ramp available at most events for individuals with limited mobility. Teams can talk to the FTA at their event to inquire about it.
Good luck, and we'll see you at the competitions.